war is about to enter a dangerous phase. Russian nukes are now not just near Ukraine, but they are close to NATO's borders too. For the first time since the fall of the Soviet Union, Russia has deployed these bombs outside the country. It's a move that cannot be taken lightly, but today it finally pulled the trigger. Russian nuclear weapons are going to Belarus.
The transfer of nuclear weapons has begun.
It has already begun?
Yes, it has already begun.
The weapons are already in Belarus?
Maybe. I'll take a look when I go back.
That was Alexander Lukashenko, the president of Belarus and a loyal ally of Vladimir Putin. Lukashenko has kept his promise. His country is now playing host to Russian nukes. The West has denounced these deployments. What made Putin resort to nuclear weapons? What is the Russian president's endgame? Let's deep dive. The war in Ukraine is in its 15th month, and both sides are battling for every inch of territory. A counteroffensive by Ukraine could begin soon, which some say has already started. But Russia is preparing. Moscow is responding with nuclear weapons. The plan was announced back in March. Belarus said today the warheads are on the move. Who are these weapons for? Ukraine. That's a no-brainer. But there could be more targets. Look at the map. Belarus shares a border with three NATO members, Poland, Lithuania, and Latvia. So these countries too can be potential targets. What kind of warheads are these? Tactical warheads. They are small in size and they are used for a limited strike. So they won't be able to destroy big cities, but they can obliterate small areas. That's their purpose. The nukes in Belarus will be controlled by Russia. So no change in ownership. But if a nuclear strike is ordered, Belarus could execute it on Russia's orders. They were given missiles that can carry these warheads. Some aircraft have been converted too. Belarusian Sukhoi 25 will be able to carry nukes. The Sukhoi 25 is a Russian warplane. The Air Force of Belarus has them. In their fleet, Belarusian servicemen got some training too. So everything is in place. The question is, why now? The Russian defense minister has dropped some hints. He was in Minsk to finalize some specifics about this arrangement to store the nukes. Listen to his comments. The collective West is essentially waging an undeclared war against our countries. The West was doing all it could to prolong and escalate the armed conflict in Ukraine. Allow me to simplify that. Russia says the war in Ukraine has turned into a proxy battle and the West wants to extend the conflict by arming the Ukrainian forces. That's the allegation by Russia. So the nukes are deterrents, a way for Russia to take control and perhaps influence the outcome of this war. The US has called Russia's move irresponsible.
I would say that we strongly condemn the arrangement. As we have made clear, the use of chemical, biological or nuclear weapons in this conflict would be met with severe consequences.
Washington has condemned the move. But what are they doing to stop Moscow? Will it change its own nuclear posture? Will America reinforce its own nuclear deterrence? The answer to that question is a no. For now, the US has decided to do nothing.
We have not seen any reason to adjust our own nuclear posture. You've heard us say that before, nor any indications Russia is preparing to use nuclear weapons. For Belarus, speaking to that particular issue, this is yet another example of making irresponsible and provocative choices. So we remain committed to collective defense of the NATO alliance, and I'll just leave it there.
So the US won't change its posture, but its ally, Japan, thinks differently. They are worried about Russia's nukes. Today, Tokyo announced fresh sanctions on Moscow. They condemned Russia's actions too.
We are aware of the announcement by both Russia and Belarus. As the only country to have suffered atomic bombings during wartime, Japan never accepts Russia's nuclear menace, let alone its use.
A nuclear menace. Japan is not mincing its words there. Expect this war of words to intensify. What about the actual war in Ukraine? Well, the fighting is escalating. Today, Russia targeted Kyiv again. More missiles and drones were launched towards Ukraine's capital. Ukraine said it shot down 10 missiles and 25 drones. There were no casualties. Russia is making moves in Crimea too. This week, Russian officials seized an apartment there. Guess who it belonged to? Volodymyr Zelensky, the president of Ukraine. Reports say the property will be auctioned, but these small